Marcus Thornton from William & Mary came in here with his own rooting section, of course. You know, they're pretty close by here. And he's the best player in the history of the school. He's the all-time leading scorer. And he's been a cause célèbre around here for 4 years because he's so good. But he's not just a hometown hero for this week. This guy's an NBA prospect.
After coming off a season with your teammates, you know, pretty much your brothers, it's just different being thrown in with a bunch of guys all trying to prove themselves. You know, you don't want to be too selfish or too unselfish. So, you know, finding that perfect balance and kind of see where you can fit in.
He's a guy that's a little light for his position. He's probably about 185 at two guard. But having said that, he has a wiry strength, and the more you watch him, the more you appreciate that. He was being guarded in the first game by Levi Randolph, who's a couple inches taller and also about 20 pounds heavier than he is. And Randolph was using his shoulders, his hands, to control Thornton. And Thornton didn't back off one bit. He didn't budge one bit. I was very impressed by that, because that's what he's going to need to do at the NBA. There's a lot of guys built like Levi Randolph who will manhandle you if you're not strong with the ball.
You know, it's obviously a grown man's game. Coming out of college, it's just an adjustment you have to make, you know, no matter how big or strong you are. Just getting used to playing with that physicality. Shot clock too, 35 seconds is a lot of time in college, you know, so 24 seconds just getting adjusted to that personal clock in your mind, I guess, as a guard. You know, you kind of have a sense of where the shot clock is.
He'll be the first one to tell you he's a scorer. He scored over 2,000 points at William & Mary, and really, if he didn't get 18 to 20 points, they didn't have a chance to win the ball game. They needed him to score a lot, and he did it consistently. The thing I really like about Thornton is he's another guy who is incredibly unselfish. The first half of his first game here, I think he took two shots, and yet when you watch the game, he was helping his team. In the second half of that game, things start to loosen up in the game a little bit, and Thornton loosened up too. He was able to start scoring the way he did when he was in college. And in the second game, I thought he was even more of a playmaker. He, again, didn't take that many shots, but he created a lot of plays for others, and I think he had 5 assists in that game. So he's done very well for himself. He's sort of that hybrid guard where he's not a true point guard, but he's also probably not big enough to be a full-time two guard at the NBA level on the wing. So he's got to be able to do a little bit of both. He's going to help his team wherever he is, whether he's in the first division in Europe or whether he's in the NBA. He's a high-level player, and I don't think a lot of people knew that before this week who scout for the NBA teams and don't see a school like William & Mary play.
My goal for me is just, you know, to improve a little bit every day, no matter how small or big. You know, it's just a continual process, so it's my job now, you know, to train, become better, and, you know, better myself as an individual on and off the court to try to, you know, contribute and be a good player on an NBA team.